Stock Market Investing for Beginners and Dummies. Author, Giovanni Rigters. Narrator, Ron Garner. Important disclaimer. This book is presented solely for educational and entertainment purposes. The author is not offering it as legal, accounting, financial, investment, or other professional services advice. The content of this book is the sole expression and opinion of its author. It is not a recommendation to purchase or sell equity, stocks, or securities of any of the companies or investments herein discussed. The author cannot guarantee the accuracy of the information contained herein. The author shall not be held liable for any physical, psychological, emotional, financial, or commercial damages, including, but not limited to, special, incidental, consequential, or other damages. You are responsible for your own choices, actions, and results. Please consult with a competent tax and/or investment professional for investment and tax advice. Introduction. It's time to get serious about your financial life and start thinking about the future. No one can and should work their whole life. You still want to enjoy life, spend quality time with your family, and your body won't let you work forever. Also, nowadays you cannot rely on a pension like in the good old days. So, it's up to you and no one else to take the steps toward building your wealth. The process is not hard, but you will have to pay attention and spend some time learning about investing. There is no way around it. There are many ways you can invest, and there are many different investment accounts on the market, but it is not too hard or complicated to weed through the investment jungle. It's also highly likely that you will start enjoying it and take it to the next level by investing in individual companies. First, we will have to start with the basics of what stocks are and what the stock market is. We'll delve into how to make money and what to do if there is a market crash. Then, we'll look at some common misconceptions and mistakes people make in the stock market. So, follow along with me as we traverse this jungle on our way to paradise. Chapter 1. What are stocks? The easiest way to get rich. A stock is simply a piece of a company. A stock represents ownership and is an asset you can buy. The people who own these stocks are called shareholders. Let's look at an example. If you and your family are going to eat a pie or pizza that has 8 slices, then everyone would get at least 1 piece or slice. Out of the 8 slices, you get only 1 and your dad gets 2. You got 1/8 or 12.5% of the pizza and your dad got 2/8 or 25%. Companies work the same way, but instead of 8 shares of stock, they could have shares of stock in the millions or even billions. McDonald's has 797 million shares outstanding. Walmart has 2.9 billion, and Facebook has 2.3 billion shares outstanding. Shares outstanding is a term used to explain the total amount of company shares on the stock market for shareholders to buy and sell amongst themselves. Shareholders can be people or different types of institutions. Also, you are not limited by geography when investing, because you can buy stocks from companies around the world. So if you want to buy stocks from companies in the Netherlands or even Brazil, you can. One thing you need to pay attention to is that there are 2 types of stocks on the market: growth stocks and income stocks. Companies that see their stock price rise up fast, like technology companies, are growth stocks. For example, Facebook and Twitter. These are rapidly growing companies, and any income they make is put back in the company for further growth and expansion. Income stocks, my favorite, are stocks that periodically pay their shareholders a dividend. This is usually quarterly, but it could also be monthly, semi-annually, or annually. The companies who can afford to pay their shareholders income are large, well-established companies, like Procter & Gamble or the Pepsi Company. There are benefits to owning both growth and income stocks. Growth stocks have the potential to increase in value fast, but they are also more volatile and risky. Income stocks, on the other hand, provide a consistent stream of dividend income, but the stock itself might not appreciate in value as fast as a growth stock. For these two types of stocks, there are also two different types of investors: growth investors and value investors. Growth investors love it when they see their stock price increase in value, also called a capital gain. They are also more willing to take on a greater risk for even greater reward. Value investors like analyzing a company's metrics and numbers and are willing to wait until it's the right time to buy shares in a company. Value investors are good at discovering great companies who are consistent performers and are likely to stay consistent in the future based on the product or services they sell in the market they are in. You might be thinking that to start buying stocks, you need to have a ton of money or be a millionaire. That's not true at all. You can start by just buying one share in a company. While I'm writing this, I saw that the Nike stock is being sold for $60, Coca-Cola for $46, and Twitter for $21. Now, this is not an endorsement to buy these three stocks. It's just an example that you don't have to spend thousands to get going. Now, with the boring definition complete, let's look at how people get rich with stocks. The four main ways people can get rich are capital gains, dividends, selling short, options trading. The last two require a bit of skill and work, and they are not as passive as the first two. Capital gains are when your stocks gain in value. The beauty of this is that you do not perform any physical labor. It's all passive. Let's say you bought 10 shares of the $46 Coca-Cola stock on Tuesday, so your stocks are worth $460. On Friday, the stocks went up to $52.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.